Hello friends, welcome to my channel. Today's topic is Mystery of Japan's Suicide Forest Aokigahara. Before going to the video, don't forget to subscribe my channel and click bell icon next to the subscribe button for latest updates. Let's go to the video. Aokigahara, also known as the Suicide Forest or Sea of Trees. Aokigahara is a forest on the northwestern flank of Japan's Mount Fuji. The total width of the forest is 30 square kilometers, aka 7,413 acres. The total forest is covered with hardened lava laid down by the last major eruption of Mount Fuji in 864 AD. The western edge of Aokigahara, where there are several caves filled with ice, is a popular destination for tourists and school trips. The Aokigahara Forest has a historical reputation as a home to ghosts of the dead in Japanese mythology. In recent years, Aokigahara has become internationally known as one of the world's most popular destinations for suicide. The Aokigahara Forest floor mostly consists of volcanic rock, which can be difficult to penetrate with hand tools such as picks or shovels. The forest is reputedly haunted by the ghost of those left to die. In 2002, 78 dead bodies were found in Aokigahara Forest. In 2003, 105 bodies were found in the forest, exceeding the previous record of 2002. In 2010, 200 people has committed suicide, and it is getting more year and year. The most common means of suicide are hanging or overdose drug. The forest is very dense and thick inside, and so sounds from inside cannot be heard outside. It is said that there are huge underground deposits of iron in the forest that interferes with the direction compass and the travelers get lost. They say that Aokigahara Forest has some supernatural force and it attracts the visitors for suicide. In Aokigahara, there is black sea of trees, which filled with evil energy that has been accumulated from all the suicides of the past. Many other ghosts and demon stories are heard about the forest. It is said that visitors sometimes see spirits in white slipping in between the trees. Do not ever leave the path, as the stories say that you can see the spirits, which looks exact like a human or your friends or family members, and mislead you for different direction. So don't trust anyone and don't leave hands and path. It's better to take some localite with you. Not everyone who goes there will die. There are a lot of tourists who visit the forest every year to enjoy the gorgeous views of Mountain Fuji and visit highlights like the distinctive lava plateau, 300-year-old trees, and the enchanting Narusawa ice cave. The forest is rich with magnetic iron, and there won't be any cell phone service or GPS systems work inside forest and even compasses. This is why if you miss the path, it's hard to find the way back. Statistics on Aokigahara's suicide rates vary, in part because the forest is so lush that some corpses can go undiscovered for years or might be forever lost. However, some estimates claim as many as 100 people a year have successfully killed themselves there. For years, the Japanese government published suicide statistics about the forest, but they have decided to not publish the data the couple of years. They believe the forest's notoriety has only increased the number of suicides the trees witness each passing year. The Japanese government is extremely eager to make the haunted forest a comfortable, non-violent tourist destination once more. One way they have attempted to lower suicide statistics is to post numerous signs along popular trailways, etched with positive messages for hikers. Some are straight to the point and list the phone number for Japan's suicide prevention hotline. Others take a more indirect approach, which request that visitor think about their loved ones, namely their families and their children. Other signs have been placed to remind visitors that their lives have meaning and purpose, that their lives are precious. As one particular sign claims, the signs may seem slightly cheesy at first, but there is no doubt that they have played a significant role in getting some people to change their minds at the end of each day with Aokigahara. It sounds grim, but many people visit Aokigahara without the intention of ending their lives. The forest has become very popular for paranormal enthusiasts, as it is said to be notoriously haunted. Japanese culture has these spirits called a yuri or ghost. It is believed that the sea of trees is littered with the ghosts who wander around between the trees late at night. Many visitors claim that they have seen numerous misty apparitions while visiting the forest, be it day or night. Disembodied voices as well as these eerie figures are enough to make anyone nervous. Typically, a ghost will appear close to the spot where a person has committed suicide. Numerous paranormal investigation teams have been out to explore the area and have successfully captured strange apparitions and disembodied voices on film. Whether an individual has morbid curiosity or simply wants to explore a legendary forest, the Aokigahara is a magical and mysterious place we are still trying to fully understand. It is believed that the spirits of those who have ended their lives continue to live in the forest, encouraging others to join them on the other side. Should you feel you are the slightest bit suicidal or depressed, visiting the forest is probably not a great idea. However, if you want to visit an emotionally charged and physically beautiful forest, the sea of trees will by no means disappoint. Guys, don't think anything about the forest. Just enjoy visiting the forest view just by taking some simple safeties such as never lay the path. Don't trust any new ones inside the forest. Don't leave hands. If you ever want to leave path, just tie a tape to the tree tightly and take the other side with you. Take some localite with you. And the last, never stay overnight. Maybe if you have weak heart, maybe the spirits can manipulate you. So return hotel before evening. That's it guys. Hope you enjoyed my video. Thanks for watching. Please like, share and subscribe my channel. Thank you.